गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. माई नेम इज जसमीत सिंह एंड माई ग्रुप इज प्रेजेंटिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 6, दैट इज स्टडी ऑफ फेज चेंज. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट माई पार्ट फ्रॉम इंट्रोडक्शन. अ फेज चेंज इज वैन मैटर चेंजेस फ्रॉम वन स्टेट टू अनदर. दिस चेंजेस ऑकर वैन सफिशियंट एनर्जी इज अप्लाइड टू द सिस्टम एंड ऑल्सो ऑकर वैन द प्रेशर ऑन द सिस्टम इज चेंज्ड. द टेम्परेचर्स एंड प्रेशर्स अंडर विच दिस चेंजेस हैपन different depending on the chemical and physical properties of the system. The energy associated with these transition is called latent heat. Some important terms are vaporization, that is an element or compound is a phase transition from liquid phase to vapor. There are two types of vaporization, evaporation and boiling. Second part, condensation, it is a change of physical state of matter from gas phase into the liquid phase and is reverse of vaporization. Third part is melting or fusion. It is physical process that results in the phase transition of the substance from a solid to a liquid. Fourth part is solidification, also known as freezing. It is a phase change of matter that results in the production of a solid. Fifth part is sublimation. It is the transition of a substance directly from solid to the gas state without passing through the liquid state. Sixth part is deposition. Deposition is the phase transition in which gas transforms into solid without passing through the liquid phase. I am going to end my part here. Now my friend Krishna will continue further.
Myself Krishna Singh. So the phase change diagram. This phase change diagram depicts the behavior of H2 at different temperatures. At 0 degrees Celsius, ice and water are in equilibrium with freezing and melting taking place simultaneously. From 0 to 100 degrees Celsius, H2 is in liquid state. At 100 degrees Celsius, water and steam are in equilibrium with evaporation and condensation take place simultaneously. And at temperature greater than 100 degrees Celsius, H2 is in vapor phase. Now, latent heat. Latent heat is the energy that is absorbed or released during a phase change of a substance. Phase change can be from solid to liquid or liquid to gas. One important property of latent heat is that the temperature of substance remains constant. Latent heat are of two types, latent heat of fusion and latent heat of vaporization. These two diagrams depict how molecules of water distributed after absorbing or releasing latent heat. Now, vaporization are of two types, boiling and evaporation. Boiling is a process in which substance changes from liquid to gaseous state, and evaporation is a process in which water changes from liquid to vapor. Boiling is a quick process and evaporation is a slow process. Bubbles are formed in boiling, whereas no bubbles are formed in evaporation. Other than this, boiling is a bulk phenomenon and the evaporation is a surface phenomenon. Boiling occurs at a definite temperature and evaporation occurred at all temperature. The source of energy needed for boiling, whereas the energy to be supplied for evaporation. Now boiling. Boiling is a convective heat transfer process that involves a change in phase from liquid to vapor. The phenomenon of boiling, opposite of condensation, is commonly encountered in the unit operations such as distillation, evaporation, and steam generation. Such a process occurs when the heat is transferred from the solid surface to liquid in contact and surface temperature is maintained at a temperature higher than the saturation temperature of liquid. Boiling process is used in boilers for steam formation, heat absorption in evaporation in refrigeration system, dehydration and drying of food, distillation of liquid, etc. The heat transfer from solid surface at TW to liquid at T saturation can be written as heat equals to H into change in temperature equals to H into change in temperature excess, where delta T is called the excess temperature. Now I end my part here. Now my groupmate Harsimran will continue further.
Myself Harsimran. Now let's know about some modes of boiling. Pool boiling. It refers to the condition in which the hot surface is some just below the free surface of a statement. Stagnant liquid and its motion near the surface is due to free convection only. Forced convection boiling. In this case, the fluid motion is provided by external means like a pump as in case of modern boilers, the forced convection improves the rate of heat transfer due to increased heat transfer coefficient. Subcooled or local boiling. This is the case of cool boiling in which the liquid temperature is just below its saturation temperature. In such a case, bubbles formed at the heated surface are condensed in the liquid as they leave the surface, as shown in diagram. Saturated boiling or bulk boiling. This is also the case of pool boiling in which the liquid is at saturation temperature. Now there are various designs of pool boiling. Free convection boiling. In this design, the exercise temperature TE is very small. The heat is transferred from wall to the liquid. Density of liquid at its surface decreases. The hot liquid moves up and the cold liquid descends and sets up free for natural convection currents. Thus, the heating in this case is by natural convection. In this case, vapor is produced at the free surface of the liquid by evaporation. Hence, this design is also known as interface evaporation. Nucleate boiling. Heat flux increases rapidly with increase in excess temperature TE. The values of the excess temperature in this range of 5 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. In this region, the bubble starts forming at a certain location on the heated surface. It represents the start of boiling process. During period, to be called regime of pool boiling, the bubbles formed are very few in number. These bubbles condense in the liquid and do not reach up to the surface of the liquid. This regime is referred to as the isolate nucleate boiling or unstable boiling. With the further increase in ascept temperature, the large number of bubbles are formed on all the surface. These bubbles grow in size and rise to the free surface of the liquid and form slugs of vapor which leaves the surface. Now I end my part here. Now my friend Josh will explain further.
Hello everyone, I am Josh and now I will explain various designs of pool boiling. Transition boiling. With the increase in temperature difference, the bubble formation is very high. These bubbles start to combine and form a blanket of vapor film on heating surface. In this design, vapor film is not stable and collapses due to this is a part of the surface will have film boiling and the remainder surface will have nucleate boiling. For this reason, this design is called unstable film boiling as shown in diagram. Next slide. Stable film boiling. Thus, the region beyond point di up to the film is stable on the surface, and this region is called the region of stable film boiling, as shown in diagram. Vapor film temperature difference. Condensation. The change from liquid to vapor is known as vaporization, and that from vapor to liquid is known as condensation. In the condensation of a pure vapor, it is necessary to remove the latent heat from vaporization. When a saturated vapor comes into contact of a cold surface or a surface in surface condenser, heat transfer from a vapor to the surface takes place and the vapor gets condensed on the surface. Condensations occur by two distinct mechanisms at very different rates of heat transfer. Two distinct mechanisms are drop-wise condensation and film-wise condensation. Now my groupmate Balwinder will further explain for the part.
Good afternoon to all. Myself Balwinder Kaur. Now I explain the two distinct mechanisms of condensation. First is drop-wise condensation. Drop-wise condensation occur when the vapor is in contact within a non-wettable surface such as a Teflon. In this, the droplet formed are merged and falls down under the action of a gravity from the surface. Condensation is it difficult to sustain gravity? The next. Film wise condensations. Film wise condensations is when a liquid film is formed on the cold surface by the vapors. This occurs when a clean, wettable surface such as the most metals is in contact with the saturated vapors. The flow of a liquid film may be a laminar if the flow velocity is relatively slow, and if the flow velocity is relatively fast, then the flow of a liquid may be a turbulent. Next slide. Yes. The comparison film condensations and row wise condensation. The condensed wets the surface and forms a liquid film. The condensed paper forms the droplets on the surface. The surface is blanketed by the liquid film, which serves as a resistance to heat transfer. The droplet slides down when they reach a certain size. No liquid film to resist heat transfer. As a result, a heat transfer rates that 5 times larger than the film condensations can be achieved. This was a today presentation from our group. Thank you.